Ciao italiani of the Europe, my name is Giuseppe, welcome back on the channel. I slightly changed the intro sentence. Instead of saying ciao Juventini of the world, I said ciao italiani of the Europe. Why? Because Italy is champions of the Euros. We won it yesterday after crazy penalty shootouts. We won it, we are in the legends. Guys, I want to start dedicating that video to Gianluca Vialli. Why? Because of two reasons. The first one, this capitano, this great man, he lifted the Champions League in 95-96 in the air for Juventus. I have these images in my mind. But not only that, yesterday he lifted also that beautiful cup again in the air. Gianluca Vialli is one that had to fight against cancer. And I want to dedicate this video also to all the people that had tough moment in their life. Why? Because you have to still believe in your dream, but not just believe and dream about beautiful dream things, but you have to fight for it. Keep fighting until the end, fino alla fine. This is the spirit. Why? Because if you keep fighting, if you believe in your dreams and you do something for it, magic can happen. So what will we do in that video, guys? No intro. We go into the Italian and international papers to see what they are saying about our beloved Italy, but then also a beautiful intro, intro of Juventus season, a beautiful update, what's going on with Juventus, because from tomorrow on, we will start speaking about Juventus. I will probably do another video about Italy, a last one, and then Juve, 100%, and starting probably this afternoon with the best of last season. Guys, don't miss that one. I want the maximum of like on the video that will probably come this afternoon, so we start immediately with Tutto Sport, who sing Siamo Solo Noi, it is only us, with a beautiful image of the team celebrating lifting that trophy with Capitano Chiellini with that cup in their hand. Beautiful image chosen as well by Gazzetta dello Sport. Troppo bello, too beautiful, Italia campione d'Europa. Should I translate that title? Absolutely not. You all understand. If you understand Italian a bit, you understand. If you understand English, you understand it as well. If you don't understand both languages, you see the images and you enjoy. The same picture was used by Corriere dello Sport saying, "È nostra." It is our, speaking about that beautiful cup. And the same image again, speaking about Inghilterra KO, England knockout after penalty shootouts. What are the Spanish papers saying? As is showing a bit more close-up of the same picture, and we clearly see Donnarumma up, and then we see centrally Chiellini and Bonucci. These guys are Juventini, our center-backs. Bravissima! Really well done for us. You know, the Spanish guys, they were celebrating and cheering for Italy like Marca. Wembleyazzo with a beautiful picture of our guys again lifting that cup in the air, and then we continue with Daily Mail. Guys, I just chose one picture. I didn't want to go too much, and I wanted to respect the opponents. England, that yesterday didn't deserve to win, but they deserve to go into the final. They started really strong. I wanted to put the respect. I could go to all the pages, all the front pages from England speaking about how sad they were. No, just Daily Mail, who said it all ends in tears. Tears for all the supporters of England, for the young players of that beautiful England team. They lost it. I know, they probably exaggerated a bit too much, putting pressure on the players like they already won. Pay attention. You have to pay attention. Nothing is sure in life. You have to play first before celebrating. But it is what it is. So for the English Juve fans, guys, I'm really sorry that you lost yesterday. I hope you are a bit happy for all the Juve players that were happy yesterday. L'Equipe, I went back to 1 month ago when they started the Euros, when they showed actually the cup in the middle with all the different players, their favorite, and we saw German players, Portuguese, French, we saw Lewandowski even, the Netherlands, and we saw England, all favorites for L'Equipe, the French paper, but no signs of Italy, and 1 month later they are saying invincible, showing actually Donnarumma and the rest of the team with Pickford on the ground. Hey, the things change. Italy was not considered by nobody as the final winner. Yesterday, before the game, on BBC, guys, on BBC, I was speaking about our capitano, Giorgio Chiellini. Probably for me, because Bonucci won it, but for me, one of the men of the matches, extraordinary of the tournament, Giorgio Chiellini. I was honored to speak about it on BBC yesterday. I'm super proud, I have to admit it. Yesterday, Chiellini received the cup from Seferin. I will not speak about that. I will not speak about that. Just watch the image. But then we go to the other image, the players arriving at in Roma. It's coming Rome and not it's coming home. And we see Capitano Chiellini with the crown of the king. King Chiellini, King Kong. Beautiful image. Yesterday, Saka, he wanted to go home. But Chiellini said, no, 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 no. You come here. Come here. What a defender, guys. What a defender's picture that will remain in the history of that tournament. The history of England, the history of the Euro. Yesterday we saw, after the game actually, Bonucci and Chiellini, best mates, they were lying in bed with the cup in the middle. The guys, look at these smiles, amazing pictures. We speak about Bonucci yesterday, he was lifting the man of the match in one hand and the cup in the other with the Italian flag. Amazing picture, I'm just showing and throwing a lot of things. Yesterday, instead of removing Coca-Cola or Heineken, yesterday Bonucci was just enjoying with all the promo material that was at his disposal. Beautiful. Look at his smile. The smile of a winner. Beautiful Leonardo Bonucci. Bonucci said yesterday, adesso siamo leggenda. Now we are legends. We were great, but now we are legends. And I just wanted to appoint one thing is, Chiellini, Bonucci never won actually an international trophy because they were not there in 2006, because they lost some finals with Juventus. Deserved trophy for our old center backs that were criticized around Europe, even in Italy. But we're speaking about the young generation, the new guys, Federico Chiesa kissing that cup yesterday. He was asking to Siri on his iPhone to call his mother. I don't have the video here, but look it on the internet. That's really beautiful moment. Federico Chiesa, they are saying that his value went sky high after that tournament. Probably the international market discovered the player that we had the luck to admire for 1 year. They are saying that his value is now going up at 80 million, guy. 80 million is not even enough. Stop about it. Forget about it. He's untouchable. Yesterday, we saw Capitano Chiellini, not only the man of the defense, but also an agent. Look at how he was kissing and hugging Locatelli on the ground. Beautiful images. And now we go into Juventus. Juventus agenda, I told you, I will speak probably one or two more times about Italy celebrating it, but then it's 100% Juventus. And we start with the calendar, because who's there to start on the 14th? So on Wednesday with Allegri, we have Arthur, Dybala, Frabotta, McKennie and Pinzolio. We have some loanies that come back like De Sciglio, Pellegrini, Perin, Piazza and Rugani. And then a few under 23 to make sure that we have a few people to train with. Da Grassa, Di Pardo, Dragusin, Fagioli, Felix Correa and Rafinha. These will be the first player that will train with Juventus, and then the other ones step by step, because they all have 3 weeks of holiday. Demiral and Chesney will be the first one to arrive and to join the team. The last one will be obviously Bernardeschi with amazing penalties, and also his free kicks was really great. Bonucci, Chiellini and Chiesa. What will happen with the South American? We are waiting for Alexandro Bentancur, Cuadrado and Danilo. They will also join the team. We start with the first friendly on the 31st of July, so it's not that long anymore, versus Monza, the team of Silvio Berlusconi, and then we start the Serie A on the 22nd of August. Champions League on the 26th of August, we will know who will be our opponents. Let's see that. Missione Allegri, the mission of Allegri starting on the 14th is to close the goals. The goal that we conceded too much in 2021. In 21-22, we will be able to count on two European champions, Chiellini and Bonucci. But we also have our boy Matthijs de Ligt. That will be a big mission for Allegri, working on the defensive phase. We will have this week a really great week as well, because after the celebration of Italy, Juventus will really start working. Locatelli, that's one man. Extension of Chiellini, that's the second thing before he goes on into holiday. And then Cristiano Ronaldo. And finishing with that news yesterday, Pinzolio on Instagram was reassuring the Bianconeri planet, saying to Cristiano Ronaldo, Cristiano, ti aspetto al campo, I'm waiting for you on the field. So Cristiano Ronaldo 90% will be again a Juve player this season. I can't wait for Juventus to come back, guys. We had a really difficult difficult season. Like Bernardeschi said, I had personally a really difficult season. He was crying yesterday, so let's cheer for our boys. For all the boys, whoever they will be in the team, whoever we will buy, whoever will remain, we have to support them because a beautiful season will be there. And hopefully at the end of the season, we as well as Bianconeri, as Juve fan, we can lift a beautiful European Cup in the air. Scudetto, Coppa Italia, Supercoppa versus Inter, whatever. Grazie. Don't forget, put a maximum of like on that one. If you arrived at the end, don't forget that one. Subscribe to the channel. Grazie, Forza Italy, and Forza Juve.